Good morning, Eagle Nation. It is Thursday, the 29th of September. It's the 41st day of school. Please join me for a moment of silence. Thank you. And now, please join me for a moment of sound. Good morning, Eagle Nation. I hate to cut that song off because that is great energy. That was Pierce the Veil with the song Bulls in the Bronx. The music group is Pierce the Veil, and this was a submission by Luna Cortez, who says about this band, Pierce the Veil, they are my favorite Mexican rock band and their song Bulls in the Bronx. This is the first time I've ever heard of them, but I'm grateful for this exposure to something new. And what I'd like to share with you about them is that this was originally started by Mike and Vic Fuentes in Southern California. Pierce the Veil's music style has generally been regarded as a mix of post-hardcore, pop-punk, experimental rock, emo, and metalcore. Their debut album, A Flair for the Dramatic, has been described as a mixture of emo, screamo, and progressive rock. According to the German music magazine Intro, the compositions on the record are complex, and they're compared them to acts like Sparta, and You Will Know Us by the Trail of Dead, and partly even to Queen. The term Mexicore has also been applied to the band due to the Spanish flair in many of their songs, which you just heard. Vic Fuentes said in an interview with Alternative Press that the band always tries to incorporate at least a hint of Latin influence in every song. Vic Fuentes described Mexicore as a mix of heavy music with a little Spanish feel. Thank you for that song submission as we continue our celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month. And let us now stop. Please stand, let us rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. We're gonna stick with our plan and knock out 22. If you'd like to join me, today's a good day. Remember, tomorrow's a day of rest. So let's finish with our push-ups for the week. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Back straight. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22. Thank you for a successful day yesterday and our cool treats visit with Phoenix Police Department. Not sure if any of you saw the news. I'm not even sure if we were on it, but they sure were here. And you guys represented us proudly. I also appreciate that everyone remained safe the entire time and continued to be respectful and responsible and caring. I didn't see any trash left over from the wrappers from the Icy Pops. So thank you, students, for taking good care of each other and good care of our space. Thank you also to Courtesy Chevrolet Automotive Group for helping us put that together as members of our community. And what makes a community strong is when people and organizations work together. We are grateful. Today is Thursday. As we look ahead to the weekend, a couple of things on the horizon. One, our volleyball team plays tonight. They want your support, they need your support, and we already support them. But if you can, come to the game tonight to cheer them on. The game is at 4:50 p.m. Also, update, flag football season has been postponed. Even though practices will continue, games will be postponed until after the October break. This is due to the incident that occurred at Garfield School. Thankfully and luckily, no one was hurt, but in an abundance of caution, the games will be delayed for a couple of weeks, but we will resume after October break, uninterrupted. So that schedule will continue, the tournament will continue, the games will continue after October break, but safety is paramount. Also, this week, our goal and our PBIS skill of the week was to practice a skill that all of you engage in every single day. It's the skill, how to get your teacher's attention. Do you know how to appropriately get your teacher's attention? How do you do it? It might sound something like this. It's a four-step process. Step one, look at the person. Step two, raise your hand. Step three, wait for acknowledgement. And this might be the hardest part, step three. Just wait. Your teacher will either make eye contact or signal you off, meaning wait or hold on, or delay your response or let you know that she's coming to you or he's coming to you, but wait for the acknowledgement. Don't just start talking out. And then step four, ask your question or make your request in a pleasant and quiet voice. This lets your teacher know that you're calm, you're composed, and that you simply have a request or are seeking knowledge, information, or permission. See if you can do it today. The goal is to do it appropriately. Look at the person, raise your hand, wait for acknowledgement, and use a calm and pleasant voice. Thank you for practicing that skill of the week. Students and teachers, thank you for introducing it to your students and reinforcing it throughout the day today and every day. All right, now some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today is on the topic of honesty. In the Philippines, there's a saying, and it goes like this. A clear conscience is more valuable than wealth. When you have a clear conscience, you haven't done anything that you might feel guilty about. So if you do what you feel is right for yourself and for others, you'll have a clear conscience, which is worth more than its weight in gold. So listen up. All the money in the world is useless if you feel guilty all the time. Sooner or later, a bad conscience will eat away at the pleasure the money may have given you. Be a truly rich person by doing what you know is right. Then sleep well at night, knowing your conscience is clear. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today as needed. And people are getting sick from the flu or otherwise, so consider it. Hats and hoods off indoors, then stay in your zones. Put away your phones and your earbuds. And then make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.